सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करम् शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम् ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। शिवगुरु एंड आर्यांबा, ए डिवोट कपल ऑफर्ड डेली वर्शिप 6 times a day for 48 days to the Lord in the Vadakkanatha temple located now in Trichur. Pleased by their worship to the devout couple, Lord Shiva himself was born as Shankara, later came to be known as Shankara Bhagavat Pada. Ajnanantar Gaganapatinatma Vidyopadeshaihi Tratum Lokan Bhavadavashikatapapachyamanan उक्त्वा मौनं वटविटपिनो मूलतो निःसरन्तीः शम्भोर्मूर्तिश्चरति भुवने शङ्कराचार्यरूपा। देर् आर् मेनी बयोग्राफीस् आफ् शङ्कर भगवत्पाद रिटन् बै वेरियस् आथर्स्. बृहत् शङ्कर विजय बै चित्सुकाचार्य, प्राचीन शङ्कर विजय by Anandagiri, Shankara Vijaya Vilasa by Chid Vilasa, and some more biographies. In the biography, Vyasa Chaliya Shankara Digvijaya, the author Vidya Shankara says that Lord Dakshinamurti himself incarnated in the form of Shankara Bhagavatpada. Shambhor Murtis Charati Bhuvane Shankaracharya Rupa. Shankaracharya Rupa Shambhoha Murtihi Bhuvane Charati Iti. For what? To release the people suffering from this heat of samsara. भवदव शिका ताप पच्यमानान त्रातुम शंभोहो मूर्ति ही भुवने शंकराचार्य रूपा चरति इति। Therefore, शंकर भगवत पादा is considered to be the incarnation of Lord Shiva himself. And the word Shankara is a compound word. In Sanskritam, a compound is called samasa. The word Shankara consists of two words, Sham and Kara. Sham means mangalam, auspiciousness, happiness. Karaha means the giver, the doer. Therefore, the word Shankaraha means the giver of Mangalam, the giver of auspiciousness, the giver of happiness. Shankaroti iti Shankaraha. Also, the word Shankara can be interpreted in another way. Shankara Bhagavatpada was born on the fifth day of the first paksha of the second month. The second month being Vaishakha Shukla Panchami. According to the Katapayadi Sankhya system, that is a system to map names to numbers, the birthday of Shankara Bhagavatpada, which is the fifth day of the first paksha of the second month. Fifth day, 5. First paksha, 1. Second month, 2. 5, 1, 2. According to this Katapayadi Sankhya system, 5 stands for the letter Sha. Five stands for the letter Sha, and 1 stands for Ka, and 2 stands for Ra. Therefore, 5, 1, 2. Sha, Ka, Ra. Therefore, Shankara iti. Iti, one more interpretation is possible for the word Shankara. And Shankara, he studied all the Vedas before he turned 8. Before 12, he became the master of all the Shastras. When he was 16, he completed writing Bhashyams to Upanishads and Brahma Sutra. What one could not accomplish, even imagine to accomplish, even in 100 years, he just did in 16 years only. Ashtavarshe Chaturvedaha Dvadashe Sarvashastravit Shodashe Kritavan Bhashyam Dvatamshe Nirabhyakat. As the Vyasacharya is considered to be an important link in the Sampradaya, because he organized and compiled the scattered Vedas into 4, so too Shankara Bhagavatpada is also another important link in the Sampradaya. During the period of Shankara Bhagavatpada, there were about 72 different cults, Visaptati Matas. They hold different views with regard to what the Veda reveals. Shankara Bhagavatpada, he conquered all of them in argument and re-established Advaita. That is why he is called Advaita Sthapakacharya. And there is an interesting story which says that once Shankara Bhagavatpada, he visited Tiruvidai Marudu. It's a place located, it's a small village located in Thanjavur district. There was a debate between Shankara Bhagavatpada and the followers of Shiva called Shaivas, Saivites. And they did not admit Advaitam. Since they did not admit Advaitam, he asked them to enter the temple. Bhagavatpada asked them to enter the temple. When they entered the temple, a voice, Advaitam Satyam, Advaitam Satyam, Advaitam Satyam. Iti, a voice was heard 3 times. It was heard 3 times from the sanctum sanctorum of the temple. From the garbhagriha of the temple, Advaitam Satyam was heard 3 times, and a hand appeared above the linga, blessing them. So this shows the verdict directly came from the Lord Himself. Therefore, Advaitam Satyam iti. And he established 4 Amnaya Peetam, 4 Amnaya Peetams at 4 corners of the Bharata Varsha during his tenure of traveling the country starting from west. He established 4 Amnaya Peetams. Paschima Amnaya Peetam, Paschima Amnaya Shri Sharda Peetam in Dwaraka in the west. Uttara Amnaya Shri Jyotir Matha in Badrika Ashrama in the north. Purva Amnaya Shri Govardhana Peetam in Puri in the east. And Dakshinamnaya Shri Shringeri Sharda Peetam in Shringeri in the south. 4 Peetams at 4 different corners of the Bharata Varsha. And the four disciples they took charge of each Peetams. Astamalaka took charge of the Sharda Peetam in Dwaraka. Thotakacharya Jyotir Mat, Puri Mat by Padmapada, and Shringeri Mat by Sureshwaracharya. By establishing 4 Mathas and placing his disciples in each of the Mathas, Shankara Bhagavat Pada, he made sure that Sanatana Dharma continues to sustain and flourish. And it is flourishing even now. And it was Shankara Bhagavatpada who restructured the sannyasi orders and organized them into 10, which is called Dashanamik Sampradaya, and gave titles like Saraswati, Tirtha, Aranya, Bharati, Ashrama, Giri, Parvata, Sagara, Vana, and Puri. And Shankara Bhagavatpada is also called Shanmata Sthapakacharya. He regularized these 6 different forms of worship. Worship of these different devatas: Ganapati, Shiva, Shakti, Vishnu, Surya, and Subramanya. Ganapatyam, Shaivam, Shaktam, Vaishnavam, Sauram, Kaumaram, iti. 6 different forms of worship were regularized. And his major contribution lies in re-establishing Advaitam in the form of commentaries to the Prasthana Trayam. Advaitam is not a philosophy. Advaitam is the truth of the reality. Advaitam is not dismissing the subject-object difference which we observe in the empirical world. In spite of duality of the world, Advaitam is the truth. Advaitam is Satyam. Appreciating the oneness in spite of the differences seen is Advaitam. Because I, the subject, observes you, the object, there are not 2 different things. The truth of the seer and the seen is one only. Oneness in spite of many things. In spite of Dvaitam, Advaitam. But then how do I account for manyness? Really speaking, there are no manyness. There are no many things. It is unreal. It is mithya. The truth is Sat Brahma. Sat Brahma is the truth. Brahma Satyam. Jivan Mithya, Jivo Brahmaiva Na Paraha. Therefore, Jivatma is Paramatma. They are not different. That is why Pujya Swamiji says, what is there is only Ishvara. We don't say there is only one God. What we say is there is only God. There is nothing other than God. And Shankara Bhagavatpada, in his introduction to Brahma Sutra, he writes a classic commentary which is popularly known by the name Adhyasa Bhashyam. Adhyasa means superimposition. Adhyasa means an error, a mistake, which is the cause of samsara. Taking a rope for a snake is a mistake, and therefore you shiver out of fear. That which is not there is taken to be there. Snake is not there, but it is superimposed to be there. Atasmin tad buddhihi. What is there is only the rope. Over the rope, the snake is superimposed. Atasmin tad buddhihi. And there are enough rooms to commit mistake, and the mistake is committed. Therefore, adhyasa is satyanrita mitunikarana, mixing the satyam and anritam, taking the anatma shariram to be satya atma, transferring the attributes of the shariram to the atma, mutual transfer, paraspara adhyasa. When the mistake is committed, the satya atma becomes as though samsari atma. Therefore, knowledge, that is jnanam, is the only means to remove the mistake and be free. No action is involved in becoming free, because you are already free, and freedom is only in recognizing it. This is the truth. This is Advaitam. Some people wrongly interpret it as Shankara's Advaitam. It is not. It is not that Shankara Bhagavatpada is the founder of Advaitam. Advaitam is a tatparyam of the Shastram. And Shankara Bhagavatpada, he establishes it by his beautiful commentaries, which are studied and appreciated by all spiritual sadhakas. And on the auspicious day of Shankara Jayanti, may we pray to Shankara Bhagavatpada to get his blessings, knowledge, and be free for ever. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantih. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.